cloud migration versus cloud transformation. In this video, we're going to talk about the difference. So many organizations are looking for what's called cloud transformation. And what they do is they go to the cloud, they take their systems to the cloud, and what they get is something called the cloud migration. So cloud migration and cloud transformation are two very different things. And in this video, we're going to talk about the difference between a cloud migration and a cloud transformation and talk about what's necessary to actually achieve a cloud transformation as opposed to just a cloud migration and why organizations are really looking for cloud transformation. If you're a cloud architect or an enterprise architect, the reason we exist is for our digital transformation or cloud transformation. So let's talk about what that is first. Cloud transformation is when an organization optimizes the way they do business at the same time they're putting their systems in the cloud. So in order for a cloud transformation to occur, prior to migrating to the cloud, the organization looks at the organization, they look at the way the people do business, and they optimize the way that the people in that organization do their jobs. That's called process optimization or business architecture optimization. And then the architect determines what types of technologies and tools can enable the organization's employees to do their job better, to deliver a better experience or a better product or a better service to the end customer. That is what you call cloud transformation. You're making the business better by looking at the organizations and tuning the organization's people and what they do, the organization's processes, and the organization's technology. That means the business is different. I'll give you an example. Netflix initially used to ship physical DVDs to our homes. And I remember it was the greatest thing in the world. I'd have to go from, say, New Jersey to England and then Dubai. I would get 5 DVDs. I'd watch them on the airplane if I had some time. And as soon as I'd land, wherever I'd land back in the US, I would drop them off in the mail and I'd get new ones. Now, in those days, that's the way we could do it. But what was different? When Netflix operated this day in these ways, individuals had very little internet bandwidth. Internet bandwidth was incredibly expensive. Companies didn't have a lot of internet bandwidth. So one day when everybody had big high-speed internet connections and companies could buy internet connections inexpensively, all of a sudden Netflix started video on demand and streaming. Now that's what you call is digital transformation or cloud transformation. That business operates in a uniquely new way, which gave it an extreme competitive advantage because of technology. That's digital transformation. That's cloud transformation. Optimize every element of that business, its people, its processes, and technology. You may also consider that to be enterprise architecture. Now let's talk about what is a cloud migration. A cloud migration is taking your systems from the data center and moving them to the cloud. So it's really, if you want to bring it back to the basics, it's moving your stuff around. So I've got a 1,000 servers in my data center. Let me move those same 1,000 servers to the cloud. That's a cloud migration. Now here's the reality. Just taking your things from one room in your house and putting them into a new room in your house probably aren't going to change much of anything. And that's why when most organizations go to the data center, if all they touch is the technology, they didn't get a cloud transformation. They got a cloud migration. All they really had was a technology replacement. So sadly, 70 to 80% of cloud migrations, where they wanted them to be their transformations, were actually just migrations. No business benefits, technology systems, or the cloud. So what's the secret to cloud transformation and making sure you do it? Align the organization's people, processes, and technology. Start with the organization's executives. Learn about their business. Learn about their needs or goals. Understand their business architecture, their business processes, their value streams, and learn how to optimize these. optimize the way people work and determine what the people that are doing their jobs need and figure out what the best tools and technologies will be to support them in their goals without regard to what technology you enjoy most or the vendor that actually makes it. That's you being an enterprise architect, a cloud architect, a strategic architect focused on cloud transformation, digital transformation, or whatever you want to talk about, as opposed to just migrating the technology. Align the people, processes, and technology, and you have magic. If you'd like to become an enterprise architect or a cloud architect or a security architect or an AI architect or even a network architect, join us on one of our free architect webinars where we'll go over the architect role. We'll talk about what we do, the kind of skills you need for that particular specific architect role. And then we'll spend as much time as we can, typically 60 to 90 minutes, answering any kind of career questions you have to help you get to your goals. And it's all free. The link for that webinar is in the description of this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe, and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your cloud architecture career, enterprise architecture career, security architecture career, AI architecture career, or network architecture career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I'll see you in another video very soon. Take care.